Henrik Grönqvist, Grönqvist. Can I say just with Henrik?
Yes.
Thank you. Hey everyone, welcome to another episode. Here we are standing in front of another Scania's facility. This is battery production factory that is still being built, and we've been lucky enough that we can take a look inside. So let's go. We are here with Henrik here, who's been kind enough to do us a private tour about their battery production facility that's being built, right? Can yes. you tell us more about this place, please?
We're standing in the construction site where we are currently building the battery factory. Scania took a decision 2019 to produce batteries in-house. We choose to do this because we see the batteries as a critical part of the electrical powertrain. The battery set a lot of the performance of the truck. It fulfills a lot of the user requirements, and that was a knowledge we wanted to have internally. So we took this decision, step one, which is not in this building, where we produce the current generation of batteries for the BEV trucks that we can see out on the market, that has been on the market for quite some time, along with hybrids and also electrical buses. In this facility, we're going to primarily increase the capacity of batteries, and we're also going to take in a new generation of batteries. So in here, we will buy cells from a supplier. That's what's like a VHS cassette, if you're that old.
I remember them.
about this big and 2 point something kilos. They will come here with some electrical current in them. In the background, you can see where we put the cells together into a battery module. And with the modules, we will, in this area down here, also put them into battery packs.
How many of these packs fits in one module?
There are 10 to 20 modules in a battery pack in the current specifications we have. And we have tailored the battery packs to fit into trucks, of course. There is so much space between the front and rear axle where you can have batteries. And we do this to have the on a long haulage truck to be able to run fully loaded for 4.5 hours, of course, which is a standard requirement in Europe to, what the driver is allowed to drive.
Yeah.
To fit into that bracket. And then, of course, we are going to use the modular system with the batteries and the electrical system to accommodate more needs that could be refuse trucks, buses, other types of needs that require more or less battery power in the trucks. So we build on the modular system to do this the same way we do with the current ICE powertrains.
Must have been quite a big decision to build your own factory, right? How long is it being built? It's like...
The decision to make batteries in-house was 2019,
okay.
If I remember correctly. The decision to build this factory was March 2020. And a year later, we did the first dig here in this area. We started to work with a number of suppliers with all the equipment to build this up. And now we are 2-3 years in. And after summer, we will start producing complete batteries and being able to deliver to
So the factory will be finished after summer this year?
Yeah, so this fall is the target to start delivering trucks. From here. We are delivering trucks, but we build the batteries in other facilities currently. In the project, we are a couple of hundred people working with this cross-functionally from Scania. We have been to our colleagues in the Volkswagen group primarily to visit different battery assembly plants that they have. We have a tight connection with R&D and tight connection with Northvolt, which is the supplier of the cell, to start this journey. The electrification is a big, big decision. Not only for a factory, but it's also, in general, it affects everybody. From the customer and how they want to and can operate their business. How do we sell what they need when it comes to electrification? How do we service, electrify the vehicles? How do we build them? How do we design them? So it's really, really through and through to do this electrification.
And Scania is taking it very seriously, right? I believe you were among the first to sign up the
science-based target.
Yeah, yes. Science-based target, right?
And that's an excellent point. We do this battery factory because the customer demands electrical vehicles. That's step number one for us. The second is to drive the shift to sustainable transport solutions, in which science-based targets is one way to measure our result. And for Scania to meet that, we have first, from our own operations, to limit our carbon dioxide footprint. We do that in the transport network, all inbound material and outbound material to and from Scania, but also in all of our factories. So to reduce the footprint from this plant, for example, we have solar panels to be installed after the winter, and we put really high effort on energy performance of this building. So the building itself will fulfill the requirements of a green building certification. Now you can certify factory buildings, but the office part of the building will fulfill that certification. So there's really those targets come through in a big way and in our operations. The targets also comes from our way of limiting the carbon dioxide footprint of the rolling fleet of Scania trucks. And to meet that, we have a few steps. We did some improvements with the new cab generation a couple of years ago. There's just launched the Super Powertrain, maybe you heard of it. That also reduces the fuel consumption by 8%. That's also an important factor. But to fulfill the requirements, we need to sell an amount of electrical vehicles starting this year, 2023, 24 and 25, to meet the target. So it's really, that's really a big driving force for us. And for me personally, that's also why do I choose to work with batteries? This sustainable transport solution, that's really a big drive for me personally as well.
It's awesome to be able to see how it actually looks in real life, you know, that to see this production factory, to see the electric vehicles and everything. That's awesome.
And I don't know if you have, I a couple of years ago bought myself an electrical car, and the performance of an electrical powertrain, that's superior, I would say, in comfort and how you drive it and how it handles. So once you go electric, you really
never go back.
Won't stay there. Yeah.
Thank you for your time, sir, and
Thank
for
you.
Your information. And
absolutely,
we will see you at the next episode.